Hello everybody, welcome to Word Shard.
Today we'll be doing the second part of the poem, The Patriot, written by Robert Browning. Okay, in the last class we had done the first part of it. Today is the continuation of the second part. Stanza 4. Till stanza 3 we had done, it was talking about the past days in the life of this patriot. And now this is stanza 4. What is it saying? Let's read. There's nobody on the house tops now. Now this one is a stark contrast, just opposite. In the last year, what we saw, that all the people were gathering on the top of the houses. They were waving their hands. They were greeting this patriot. Okay, but now what has happened? This is a contrasting image. There is nobody on the housetops. On all the tops of the houses, there were people just 1 year back. Now there is nobody. Just a palsied. Palsy is a kind of disease. Okay, palsy is a disease where it is a kind of paralysis. Okay, and the hands and legs shake at times. Okay, this is the disease. There are few palsied people who are sitting at the window set. So, why is the word palsied used over here? It is a kind of disease. Why is this kind of a disease talked about here? Because there are a few people who are sitting like a paralyzed person by the side of the window, looking and accepting whatever is happening to the patriot. So the patriot was humiliated. He was dragged all through the road. Okay. But there was nobody to protest against such a misbehavior towards their beloved patriot. We see that the roads are empty. This picture is showing that the roads are empty. On all these buildings, people used to stand over there and wave their hands to greet the patriot. But now nobody is there. Only at a number of windows here and there, there were few people sitting and watching this humiliation of their patriot. How was the patriot humiliated? Let us see. For the best of the sight all allow at the shambles gate. Where are these people? Those people who were standing on the roads, on the top of the buildings, everywhere, who were greeting the patriot in the last year. Where are these people? All these people have gone to the shambles gate. What is a shambles gate? Shambles gate is a place where people are hanged. Okay, people are taken and they are hanged from there. They are hung from there. So this is a place where people are hung. So the gate of that place is called the shambles gate. People gather here to watch somebody being hanged. So when a criminal is being hanged, then all the people go near the gate and watch it. Okay, that is the shambles gate. So where is this patriot being taken? He is being taken to the gallows to be hung. Okay. Or better yet, by the very scaffold's foot. What is a scaffold? Let us see a picture. See, this one is a scaffold. This is a raised platform, okay, from where the person is hung. This is the rope and the man is taken to this place to hang him from this rope, okay. This is a raised platform. This one is called the scaffold. Now all these few of the people are this is a place, and outside it there is a door also. Some people are standing in front of the door, okay, to see their patriot being hung. Okay, some people are overexcited. They have gathered where? Just close to this platform where he would be taken up to be hung. Okay, they were so excited. Once they loved their patriot so much, they could give away their lives for him. Now what is the condition? Now they are excited to see him being hung. Okay. Let us see the summary. At present, the patriot is being taken to the scaffold or the gallows where the criminal is hung for his crimes. Now, criminals are taken to the gallows, isn't it? Why will a simple person be taken to the gallows? Obviously, people have thought that their patriot has become a criminal. There is nobody on the housetops now, just a few at the windows who seem to be paralyzed. Few paralyzed people seem to be paralyzed. Why? It is said that they are paralyzed because they do not revolt. They do not oppose to whatever is done to the patriot. Okay? They do not protest against such treatment to their beloved leader. Most of them have gathered at the shambles gate or close to the platform where he is going to be hanged. So he is being taken, dragged and pulled to the shambles gate to be hung. And all the people are just watching and they are excited that he will be hung. Okay. They're excited and happy that the patriot is going to die for his misdeeds. This word misdeeds, what does it signify? That they have accepted that the patriot is a bad person. They have that patriot has done a lot of wrong things, and that is why it is good that he's being hung. Okay. Let's see the figures of speech over here. First one is a contrasting imagery and irony. We have already done this contrasting imagery. If I place a black color just beside a white color, then it is a stark contrast, just the opposite colors, one after the one beside the other. In this case also, we see that all the walls were shaking. There were so many people on the tops of the buildings that the buildings seemed like they were swaying, they were moving to and fro. But now nobody is there. So that is a contrasting imagery. Which one? That image of house roofs seemed to heave and sway. Just 1 year back, the house roof seemed to move because so many people have gathered on the top of the buildings and they were waving their hands. But now what is the situation? There is nobody on the house tops. This is a contrasting imagery. Once there were all the people gathered over there, and now there is nobody over there. This is the contrasting imagery. This is the irony, as the same people who almost worshipped him now are cheering at his execution. This is such a strange thing, isn't it? Once upon a time, they could sacrifice everything for this person, worshipped this patriot. Now, what is the situation? Now, they are very excited. They are cheering that this patriot is being executed. Okay, let's move to stanza 5. What is written? I go in the rain, and more than needs, a rope cuts both my wrists behind. Now we'll see this picture. See this? Over here, the hand is tied by the help of a rope. Okay. The hand of the patriot was tied like this behind him. Okay. And it was tied so strongly. It was tied so tightly that it was cutting into his flesh. It was cutting his skin. It was so tightly tied. Okay. And I think by the feel, my forehead bleeds. Now the hands are tied behind him. He cannot touch his forehead and feel, isn't it, that whether the head is bleeding or not. But he could feel that blood was dripping from his wounds. Okay. Why was blood on his forehead? His head was in this state. Why was it his head in this state? Because for they fling whoever has a mind. That is, whoever wants, they just threw stones at this patriot, stones at me for my year's misdeeds. This is another contrasting imagery, isn't it? Once upon a time, just 1 year back, they were greeting him with what? Myrtles and roses, isn't it? And now, what is the situation? They're greeting him with what? They're greeting him with stones. They have tied their hands with rope, his hands with rope, and they're flinging stones at him. Let's see the summary. The speaker is now moving in the rain. Now, this is also a very important symbol. Okay, we'll remember this. We'll study this after some time. The speaker is now walking. It is raining heavily and he is walking through the roads. Where is he going? He is going to the shambles gate. He is going to be hung. And his hands are tied tightly. And the wrist pains as the rope is too tightly tied. It cuts through his skin. The skin is being cut because the rope is tied very harshly around him. Stones are thrown at him instead of flowers, and his forehead is bleeding. He can feel blood oozing out from the wound. He could feel, he could not touch it because his hands were tied, but he could feel that his forehead was bleeding. Let's see the figures of speech. First one, what is a pathetic fallacy? This is very important. Okay, this is a new one, so try to understand. What is a pathetic fallacy? This is very easy. See, when we say personification, we give human attributes to non-living things. If we say the table is crying, then a table is an inanimate thing, isn't it? Table is a dead thing, non-living thing. And I am giving a quality which is good for a human being, which a human being is capable of. Crying. Who is capable of crying? A human being is capable of crying. A living thing is capable of crying. So I'm giving the qualities of a living being to a non-living thing. That is a personification. And in this case, pathetic fallacy means when we provide the emotions of a human being to natural elements, to nature's elements. If we say that the sky is weeping, so this is sky is a natural element, and we are saying that the sky is weeping. Who can weep? Human beings can weep. Living things can weep. So if we give the qualities of living things to the nature, to the elements of nature, the sun, moon, sky, wind, these, then it becomes a pathetic fallacy. See, it is said that it rains. It seems that the whole earth, that the sky, that the clouds, they are weeping, they are crying. Why? Because they are also feeling sorry for this patriot, at the condition of the patriot. Okay. He had done a lot, isn't it? In the last class only we knew that he had done a lot. He could do, he did everything that was possible for him. And now this is the condition he is facing. So even the cloud and the sky and the whole earth feels sorry for him, but the people does not. In the rain, the patriot is pulled and humiliated. Important word, he is humiliated while taking him to the gallows. So he was being pulled and dragged to the gallows, and in the meantime, he was humiliated. It seems that even nature weeps at such humiliation. This is the important point. What is a pathetic fallacy? Way of attributing human emotions to natural elements, nature's elements. Over here, we see that the sky seems to weep at such humiliation of the patriot who had done so much for his people. Rain cleanses him. That means rain purifies him and cleans him of guilty. He is proved innocent. It seems that the sky, that the earth knows that this man is innocent, and it is very wrong to do such a thing with the patriot who has done so much for his people. Now we move to the second figure of speech. This is a contrasting imagery, just like the last one. We see that stones are flung now, but just a year back, what was flung? Myrtles and roses. He was greeted with myrtles and roses just a year back, and now he is greeted with what? With stones. Okay, we'll move to stanza 6. This is the last stanza. Let's read it. Thus I entered. Entered where? Thus I entered the gallows. I entered the shambles gate. Now I am going inside the... He was carried all... He was pulled all along the road to be, and was taken where? To the shambles gate, where he will be hung. So now he has reached this shambles gate. Okay, so he entered the shambles gate and he says, thus I go. Where will he go? He will be hung over there. So he will die. He will leave the earth and go. In triumphs. In triumphs means in victory. People have dropped down dead. Paid by the world. That means he is obviously not satisfied. He is depressed. He is sad by the way world, the people of the world has treated him. He is very sad. Sorry. What dost? Dost means do. Thou, you, owe me. God might question. Now instead, it's God shall repay. Now he ends the poem in a very optimistic end. That means a very positive note. He ends the poem in a very positive note. He was mistreated. He was humiliated, his dignity was wiped away, isn't it? Yet he ends the poem in a very positive note. He says that, okay, I am dying. I know that I was not treated well. I did a lot for my people, yet I was not treated well, yet I did not get justice. I was humiliated and killed and was hung. Okay, but where am I going? I will go to God. And God is a person who knows everything, isn't it? He is an omnipotent, omnipresent person. So this God is aware of what I have done, and he also knows that I was not treated well by my people. So he will give me justice. So now I am dying, I will go to God, and then in the presence of God, I will feel safe. I know that God will give me justice. God will treat me well. Okay, so let's read the summary. The poem has an optimistic end. This we'll have to remember. This is a very religious kind of a poem. This person, the patriot or the speaker, has a belief, has a strong belief, has a strong religious belief. He believes in God. He believes that God will treat him well. The patriot now has entered the shambles gate. He will be hung soon. He will thus go from earth to God's care. He knows that he is going to God, and he will be in God's care. He will not be misunderstood again, because obviously God knows everything. God cannot misunderstand anybody. He believes that even in victory, people drop down dead, but God will judge him well. Obviously, maybe his people could not treat him well, but God will know everything. God will judge him well. He will give him justice. He didn't receive his reward in this world, whatever he has done. He was waiting for the harvest, isn't it? He thought that the result would be very good. When he has done so much for his people, he would be paid well. For example, if we study throughout the year. We will obviously expect good marks, but ultimately after the exam, when the results come, if we see that we have failed, then it is a very huge shock. In the same way, this patriot also feels very sad that I did so much, but my people are so annoyed with me. They do not love me. Okay. They have forgotten my deeds. They are humiliating me. So I did not get a reward from this world, but God knows everything. He will give me justice. He feels safe in the hands of God. That's all. Now, the figures of speech. Alliteration. See the poem. In the last stanza, we see drop down dead. What is alliteration? Repetition of the consonant sounds. The letter D is repeated. D drop, D down, and D dead. So this is an alliteration. Now, there are some very important themes in the poem. This we will have to remember. Okay, there are two important things. We'll remember that, and that's done with the class. We are done with the class then. Themes. First one is public fickle-mindedness. What do you mean by fickle-mindedness? For example, if I want to go out and play just now, and then immediately I feel, no, I don't want to go and play. I want to see a little bit of television. Then I immediately decide, no, I will not watch television. I will play video games. So I constantly shift my thoughts. Constantly I am shifting in deciding what I need to do, what I want. Okay. So it identifies public fickle-mindedness. Public is very fickle-minded. Once they love you, once they hate you, maybe at the immediate next moment, they will start hating you. Over here, just 1 year back, they loved their leader so much, they could do anything for him. And now what has happened? Now he hates him like anything. The poem is a harsh satire on public fickle-minded attitude. So it is a harsh satire. It identifies public fickle-mindedness, that they do not hold strongly on whatever they are doing. They don't understand what they are doing. Once they hate, once they love, immediately they might hate you again and love you in the next moment. So honor and respect is momentary, and it can suddenly change to extreme hatred. So immediately you can be hated. Once in the first, maybe in the morning you are loved, in the evening you are hated. So that kind of a nature is owned by the people. The contrasting images in the poem suggest the same. This is the contrasting image. Once he is welcomed with myrtles and roses and people are waving their hands and doing what not. And in the next moment, he is being dragged through the streets, through the same road, and he is humiliated. His dignity is wiped out. He is stones are flung at him. Okay. This is such a contrasting behavior in the people. Okay. Next, last one, faith in God. In the end, we see what? The poem ends with a line, it is God shall repay. I am safer so. This is am. So he believes that, okay, I am not treated well by my people, but I know that I will get justice when I be close to God. So he ends with an optimistic, positive end. Even though the world thinks that the patriot has done nothing wrong, although the world thinks that he must have done something wrong, he knows that he has done everything he could do. He very well knows that he did everything that was possible for him. Death is not the end. He believes that God will give him justice, as he was not rewarded for his good work in the world. He knows that he has done whatever he could do. Now God knows everything. God will give him justice. Maybe his people misinterpreted it. Maybe I wanted to teach you and I wanted you to score good marks, but you could not. Then maybe you will feel that I am not good enough. But maybe I also am feeling that, okay, I have done my best. So this is a misinterpretation, isn't it? So that is what the patriot feels, that maybe when I go close to God, then God will be able to understand what I have done for my people. The poem reflects Browning's faith in God. So this identifies the poet Robert Browning's faith. What is the faith? God is in his heaven and all is well with the world. Now God is in heaven. God is in his heaven and all is well with the world. Everything is okay when God is there. You will get justice sometime or the other. Okay, that's all for this chapter. Next, we'll move on to questions in the next class. Thank you so much. If you have liked my video, please like, comment, and subscribe, and also share it so that all your friends can see it. Thank you so much, children.